This presentation is going to examine the concept of population structure. And population structure can be defined as the composition or makeup of a population, which includes various types of subpopulations. Population structure is not a measure of population size. Small countries and large countries can be comprised of smaller subpopulations, and they may be dense or not. That's sort of irrelevant to the notion of structure. There are two basic types of structural characteristics, which are the nature of the subpopulations we mentioned. Those are the biological characteristics and the cultural characteristics. And the most commonly referred to biological structural characteristics are age and sex, and with regard to culture, it's class, race or ethnicity, and education. But there are others that could fall into both categories, as we'll see. There are a number of different ways of examining structural characteristics, and a common way to do that within demography is to look at various ratios. So, for example, the sex structure, we could examine by looking at the sex ratio, and you can see the formula for that is simply SR equals M divided by F times 100. So in this case, we're going to get the ratio of males to females, right? M is males, F is females. If we examine age structure, we can come up with a similar type of equation. But the ratio is not the only way to measure age structure. The median age is a good way to look at that because it's a different type of variable. Because sex is a nominal categorical variable, ratios are more commonly examined. Age, however, is a continuous variable. We look at things like central tendency. But we can also break them off into categories we call cohorts, which are age groups. And we can look at those the same way as we do these sex ratios, as relative proportion of one cohort to the others. And so the percent of a given age, for example, would be the formula cohort over P times 100. Urban structure is measured as the equation shows here, as equal to the urban population divided by the total population times 100. And one could also imagine looking at an urban-rural ratio using the same basic equation as the sex ratio, except replace male and female with urban and rural. That would be another possibility. And of course, economists would be interested in something like the employment structure, where the unemployment rate is calculated by examining the population of unemployed relative to the total labor force multiplied by 100. And finally, we can think about studying racial and ethnic structure by looking at either the percentages in each category or by looking at the total number within the population or the subpopulations that we're studying. Of course, when it comes to race and ethnicity, there's a world of controversy with regard to definition and measurement. The United States Census, for example, has altered the way it measures these things on several occasions, switching the names of categories, for instance, and more recently, in 2000, allowing people to select more than one category, so allowing multiracial identities.